So I gotta know, you ever go out and take some night sky photos looking for the stars or the Milky Way or something else, and you find that your horizon is full of an orangey yellow glow? Has that ever happened to you? Definitely me too. So the reason for that orangey glow on the horizon is basically a simple problem that a lot of us have that don't live in darker sky areas, light pollution. What causes this light pollution? Basically, every light that you see on in your town, whether it be digital signage, street lights, building lights, anything that's out there for some safety and security, all of this creates this light pollution, creates a light dome over your town, city, or where have you. This can also be exacerbated by other forms of pollution, whether it be smog or dust in the air or smoke from wildfires, whatever. Plus humidity, that could exacerbate these things. So all of this causes that kind of orangey glow, orange and yellow glow on the horizon. This even happens in dark areas that are relatively close to towns. Like recently when I was in the Alabama Hills in the last video, one of the things that I had noticed was I had a little bit of a glow off to the left side because of being in close proximity to lone pine. So through a little bit of research on the internet and understanding a little bit how light performs, I was able to pick up the NiSi Natural Night filter. This filter is meant specifically for night photography and star photography because it allows you to filter out the actual wavelengths of the light that's caused by light pollution. So I bought this one in a 95 millimeter thread, so that way it'll fit my Irix 15 millimeter lens, much like what I was shooting with out in the Alabama Hills. So what this does, when you think about the light spectrum and all the different colors in that spectrum between infrared and ultraviolet, this filter has coatings on it that will block out a specific range of that spectrum, specifically in the 575 to 590 nanometer range. So this is the range where your yellows and oranges are coming into play. This filter is coated, has coatings on it that work against that range of spectrum. So now this doesn't work as a miracle cure, all right, because it's not going to completely block out all the light that you want it to block out, but it will certainly reduce, not necessarily eliminate, but reduce the unwanted light coming into your lens. This helps you increase the contrast in the stars that you're trying to take, any night sky objects that you're trying to take, to overall help with the end result of your photo. So now how do I use this? So I've said it before that I have been taking some of my night sky photography with my Irix 15 millimeter lens. Reason for this being is it's a fixed focal length lens, a prime lens, if you will, with a manual focus collar on it. There's no autofocus on this lens whatsoever. So it makes it nice to be able to set things up and basically do a set it and forget it type scenario. So what I do, because I bought the filter specifically for this lens with the 95 millimeter ring, the filter goes right onto the front of the lens, just like this. So that way you have everything is fixed. So it works like any other standard circular filter that way. It's not magnetic or any of that other stuff. But now that the filter is on the lens, I'll set it up for my night sky photography. So one of the things that you want to do with night sky photography is you want to make sure that it's on a tripod. So that way you are stable, you're not moving, and you can quite literally set it and forget it using an interferometer. I'll get it set up on the tripod. I'm obviously doing this inside because I tried recording some of this on another recent trip that I had taken, and it was so dark that all you could hear is me talking, some waves crashing, and you couldn't see anything. So for right now, we're inside on the tripod. So for settings, what I'll usually do is anywhere around ISO 2500 to 3200, even as far as 6400, depending on the scenario. I talked about it last time a little bit when I was set up to take photos in the Alabama Hills, where I had the camera set up for 15 second intervals or 15 second exposures. I tend not to use the NPF rule for the 6 seconds to get those fine pinpoint stars, because I find that it doesn't always collect as much light as I want without having to bump up the ISO too high. So I'll usually split the difference between that NPF rule and the rule of 500, so that way I can go around 15 seconds. Gives me enough light, enough data to get a good photo out of the experience. From that, I set up the intervalometer. Set it, forget it, let it take its pictures. I check on it every few photos or so, so that way I can make sure that I'm A, pointed in the right direction still, or nothing has knocked the camera at all. So the results of that are from my two recent trips. Obviously, the Alabama Hills trip, the first photo that I'm going to show you, is a result of taking 251 photos and stacking them all together to get this photo. And then recently, I was on the coast of Maine, down east Maine, if you will, and had an opportunity to take some night photos. So I did the same over the harbor along the coast in Maine and was able to achieve this photo with about 130 photos stacked upon each other. Of course, with every piece of gear that you get or every piece of equipment that you have, there's going to be pros and cons that go with it. Plus, I have a couple of little tips as well. Some of the cons are not exactly cons, but they're inherent to the type of filter that it is, but we'll go over that in a second. For the pros, obviously, we're eliminating that yellow-orange sky glow that happens from the light dome from the towns and cities that we're near. Like I said, you're still going to see this if you're in a dark area that's near a town or whatever. It may not be as pronounced, but this filter does help reduce that a lot, which is really nice. The next thing that's a pro with this is, because you're reducing that sky glow and you're reducing those yellows and oranges, you're helping to bring out some contrast in the stars that you are capturing at the time as well. So that helps keep the natural color of the stars or any other colors that will be seen in the sky. So for cons, like I said, some of these are inherent to the type of filter that it is, but it's also something that you should also keep in mind as well. This is not going to help in heavy light pollution, or it won't help as much in heavy light pollution. So if you're trying to take night sky photos in, say, New York City or Los Angeles or something, there's going to be a lot of light pollution there that you're going to be contending with. And it's not just the color of the light pollution at that point, it's the light pollution itself that is going to be stopping you from getting star photos. So like I said before, this is not going to eliminate your light pollution. It does reduce it, but it doesn't eliminate it completely. But if you're in a super bright area, it's really not going to do much for you in that respect. So one of the other things that it does, I don't know if you can tell here, it's got a slight color to the lens because of the coatings that they put on that to block out the range of light spectrum that creates the color, that creates those sky glows. So what ends up happening is you get a little bit of a color cast that goes along with this as well. And it's just inherent from the type of filter it is. It's got a little bit of a purpley kind of hue to it a little bit. If you take a really close look at my Alabama Hills photo, you really got a pixel peep, but if you look along the horizon where it was kind of hazy and dusty and humid, that area is actually has a little purple hue to it. I tried to reduce it the best I could, but I couldn't do it without damaging the photo. So you will get a slight color cast that you'll have to correct in post. The last thing is, again, inherent to filters in general, you're adding another glass element to the front of your lens. This has the potential for causing reflections or lens flares or anything else like that if you have some, you know, light that comes in. If you're taking night photos and somebody drives by, you might get some flaring in there because of the extra element. Again, this is going to be inherent to filters in general, but something to keep in mind. For a few tips to help you out with these kind of things, obviously the one is kind of, I would almost say, self-explanatory, but also not accessible to everybody. The first is try shooting from higher elevations. Luckily, when I was in the Alabama Hills, I had the ability to shoot from higher elevations to kind of get above some of the dust, get above some of the haze, stuff like that. You may not have that opportunity, but if you are in an area where you're going to have some of that humidity or smog or pollution that kind of hangs out in the valley, go find a hilltop that you can shoot from. You might be able to find some other compositions that go along with it to bring your stars out. Another thing, and again, might be kind of obvious, don't shoot in the direction of the light domes. You know, if you're, you know, like where I'm at in the Hudson Valley, I have New York City that's going to be directly in my view. So there's a large light dome that comes out of New York City. So that's something that I don't necessarily want there. So I might go to the west or to the east somewhere so that way I can take these photos. So just to wrap things up here, if you guys have experienced any of these kind of sky glow scenarios and have solutions for them, please let me know in the comments what you've done to help in the past. A single filter is not a one size fits everything kind of thing. Your mileage might vary. Somebody else might have tried something different that has worked for them. The other thing is, if you're interested in this filter at all, I do have a link that is going to be in the description. It does contain affiliate links, does support the channel a little bit, but I will make sure to have a link for this filter in there so that way if you want to pick one up, you have the ability to do so. Thank you very much for coming with me on this. I really do appreciate everybody's support. Make sure to get out there, take some great photos, and I'll see you again next time.